WeatherScope is brought to you by Chevrolet Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
This is WeatherScope.
Yet another Pacific storm is bringing rain to California as we speak. We are looking at a busy travel day being slowed down by all the showers and maybe even a thunderstorm. Good afternoon. I'm Lisa Moser.
And I'm Declan Cannon. That's right. We've had a couple of big storms already producing hail, gusty winds in Alabama and Tennessee. And we'll talk more about why the severe weather in just about a minute or so. But let's first look at some of the wet weather. In fact, in Atlanta earlier today, well, there were some clouds at the Hartsfield International Airport to start the day with some rain, but the sun broke out. And now it looks like with a little bit of heating and the approach of a cold front, showers and even some isolated hail-producing thunderstorms will cross North Georgia for the remainder of the afternoon into this evening. In Tampa, clouds and light rain fell across the vicinity. Not exactly a great day to be out in the boat. Others did decide to get out and do the normal jog. And the rain, although it hasn't been very heavy, certainly has kept the temperatures down today. We've been in, well, the low 70s, upper 60s, and we still can't get rid of all the cloud cover. As you can see on the satellite view, there are more clouds coming our way. Southwest winds ahead of the front, so we've kind of tapped into the tropics across the east side of the Gulf. Notice the lack of clouds as we get here into the western and central Gulf. There's a west-northwesterly push, our cold front cutting down through here. Now here's the setup for the severe weather. It cleared out early this morning from Georgia westward to Alabama. The sun warmed up the low levels, it got warm enough, and then a very cold pocket of air started to head east. This is the upper low moving across Tennessee, Alabama, heading towards eastern Tennessee and North Georgia by early this evening. It's the upper low with this cold air moving over the warmed air from the sunshine that's giving us this big temperature change from ground level up to about 20,000 feet. That big temperature contrast makes the atmosphere very unstable, and with the front also pushing to the east, we will see additional showers and thunderstorms, some occasionally quite intense. The hail is possible with some of the storms in addition to the gusty winds, and you can see the front does stretch east of Mobile. There's that other pocket of rain across Florida, another front trying to work its way into the upstate in South Carolina. Now we have two severe thunderstorm watches, the most recent one issued for northern Georgia, eastern Tennessee, heading over towards a small section in southwesternmost North Carolina. There is a little bit of rain in the southwestern counties as you get into North Carolina, but this is the main part of the severe weather threat from Tennessee into North Alabama. We've had some hail with the storms in Madison County, Alabama. Also, as you head into Tennessee, Perry, Bedford, Marshall, Giles, and Lawrence counties have had some pretty heavy rain and some gusty winds and some hail with these thunderstorms. In Florida, now there's Tampa, almost on the northern edge of some of this more significant rain south of town. We go down to Sarasota and we're in the rain. A thin line of thunderstorms right at the very leading edge, and it's warm today. 84 at Miami. It was up to the 86, 87 degree mark about 2 hours ago. 70 now in Tampa, warming up just a tad. 64 in Atlanta and Birmingham, and then we have a relatively cool 49 in Oklahoma City, and that's actually not too much warmer than the 45 you have as far north as Detroit, Michigan. How about 53 degrees in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania? The cooler air, at least what we have of it, is located over central and northern New England, and with cold air here and the moisture coming up from the southwest, a little patch of freezing drizzle, freezing rain, western Massachusetts, southern Vermont, and New Hampshire. We'll get primarily rain into this evening, but the forecast gets a lot more interesting, as you'll see in a moment. Look at all the rain from New York City heading southwest. If you're going to be traveling today from the city down to Philly, D.C., or perhaps you're going to head west on the PA Turnpike to Harrisburg or Pittsburgh, there's just plenty of rain, and you're going to need extra time today with the wet roadways and now the possibility of some hydroplaning. Always got to be a little concerned about that, especially at 55, 65 miles an hour. Notice the rain, too, extending all the way back into southern Illinois. But notice the northern edge, it is shifting southward as we go through the last couple of hours, and we do have that cold front which continues to work its way across southern Wisconsin. Plenty of low clouds with that front as it's moving past Madison, Wisconsin. Lisa?
Okay, and I'll check the forecast, Declan, if you'll check to see what the latest severe thunderstorms are going on right now. The Los Angeles area is getting rain as a new system makes its way along the West Coast. And those of us in the region could even see some thunderstorms, okay? So we'll be watching out for that. Know what your safety measures are in the event of some severe weather. Right now, we're looking out at the Pacific, the Gulf of Alaska, showing us that we have quite a bit of cloud cover. We've had some snow to accumulate in along Anchorage, Alaska, Bethel, very windy. Looking at our feature towards the center of California, this was associated with some of the low pressure that is now moving in towards Alberta, Canada. What we're seeing was the division of this piece of system. This system kind of broke apart. The surface feature now on its southerly track is still associated with a disturbance aloft, but a smaller cool pool of air aloft. That's going to, I point that out because that's going to come inland, in along the Los Angeles vicinity. And so what we're seeing now is this moisture, this line of moisture feeding into our surface low area. That's bringing us some showers. Some of the showers have been heavy at times, but we are still talking about basically